Good morning, everyone. I'm Dr. Aniket Rai. I'd like to thank AIF for giving me this opportunity today to present this. I'm presenting here my case on a CNVM in a young adult, which is a rare case, of course. So a 24-year-old female patient presented to us with complaints of blurring of vision in the right eye for the past 1 year, which was gradual and progressive to the present stage. It was painless in nature. There was no similar previous history of any eye problems in the past or any glass user surgeries. There were no other systemic abnormality. The best corrected visual acuity of the right eye was 660 and the left eye was 6x. The intraocular pressure of the right eye and left eye was 16 and 17 mm respectively. The color vision was normal. Anterior segment was unremarkable. On examination of posterior segment, the optic margins were well defined. A grayish black choroidal lesion of approximately 2 inches diameter was seen in the macular area with the central yellow area suggestive of a scar. There were multiple round yellowish choroidal lesions seen superior and inferior to the optic nerve without any signs of intraocular inflammation. This was the color fundus photo showing the posterior pole and the periphery of the right eye with the macular gray lesion with the central yellow lesion suggestive of a CNVM and the periphery showing multiple punctate yellow choroidal lesions suggestive of multifocal choroiditis. The OCT of the macula showing a subfoveal CNVM complex with distorted foveal contour and the central macular thickness of 68 microns. This is the FA photo of the same showing arterial phase of a posterior pole revealing hyperfluorescent lesions in the early phases, increasing in density in the later with a hyperfluorescent halo around it, suggestive of a CNVM. Multiple hyperfluorescent lesions seen superior and inferior to the temporal arcades, corresponding to the choroidal lesions seen in the clinical picture. There were multiple lab results which we did and which suggestive of a normal hemogram with elevated ESR, a normal CRP, chest X-ray was normal, MON2 was normal, BDRL showed no positive results, IgG, IgM for TORCH panel were negative. HLA B27, B5, B29 were showing a negative result. She was treated with a 3-monthly intravitreal aflibercept 2 mg in 0.05 ml combined with oral steroid, following which her best corrected visual acuity was 6/12. OCT revealed inactive or scarring at the CNVM region where no activity present on OCT, showing a CNVM complex with a CMTA of around 16 microns. The peripheral lesion did not show any activity and she was maintained on a regular follow-up. So I'd like to discuss that punctate linear choroidopathy is a rare idiopathic inflammatory multifocal choroidopathy that predominantly affects young myopic women. It is characterized by small multiple round yellow-white punctate lesions seen in the posterior pole, rarely extending to the mid-periphery, apparently in the absence of intraocular inflammation. These lesions may evolve variably into deep punched-out punctate scars with the surrounding hyperpigmentation with atrophic changes at the level of inner choroid and retinal pigment epithelium or subretinal choroidal neovascularization. Diagnosis was based on the visualization of multiple small between 100 to 300 micrometer round yellow choroid punctate lesions seen on fundoscopy and in the absence of ocular inflammation elsewhere in the eye. Although it may be self-limiting with a favorable outcome, inflammation or neovascularization affecting the fovea may cause permanent visual loss. Thus, I like to conclude that CNVM in a young patient should be evaluated in detail for the root cause. CNVM secondary to multifocal choroiditis usually gives a good visual prognosis when diagnosed early and timely treated. Thank you.
Nice presentation, Dr. Aniket.
Thank you, sir.
My first question is, why was aflibercept chosen as the treatment of choice for CNVM?
So there was no specific predilection towards aflibercept. We decided so that it was already going towards a scarring stage and we thought aflibercept would have a better role if we go directly with that, even though it could go along with Avastin or ranibizumab.
Yeah, and second, why can't it be birdshot?
So as shown in the fundus picture, it was not typically starting with the optic margin and also it was not, the HLA markers were not present in that. So we were not thinking in those aspects.
All right, thank you.